Greetings to you all in the marvelous name of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm so glad once again with you with the Word of God. And welcome to Bible God Answers. Bible God Answers is the program that is exclusively for answering the questions from the Bible. I hope that these videos are helping you to understand what is going to happen in the future and what is the things that are related to the eschatology. So, what is eschatology? So, today we are going to look at this question, what is eschatology? So, what is Christian eschatology? Because eschatology deals with the end times. So, every religion talks about the end times and talks about the things that are going to happen in the future. So, particularly, what is Christian eschatology? We are going to look at this question today. So, Christian eschatology is one of the stream in the systematic theology. So systematic theology deals with so many theological streams. If you look at one by one, we can see that what is systematic theology. You can also see what is systematic theology means. Systematic, from the word itself, we come to know that the systematic. Systematic means arranging all the things or sum up all the things into one consideration, in one asset. If you look at there, if you look at the example from the Bible. So, Bible talks about the sin. Bible talks about the sin in different books. If you look at the 66 books of the Bible, in 66 books of the Bible, sin was presented over there. And sin was presented in a different manner. And when the sin came and how it came, how it is going to be, the consequences of sin and what is sin, what are the different types of sin, and what sin gives the consequences. These are things are there. So if you sum up all the related information, all the information that are related to the sin, it is called as the HOMOSEXUALITY. Hamartia means sin. Hamartia is a Greek word that means sin. So it is considered as the Hamartiology. So in the same way, systematic theology has almost several branches, several stream. For example, there are some main streams in systematic theology. If you look at them, theology proper, it is also called as the patriology. Patriology means it is the study of God the Father. It is the study of God the Father and how the God the Father was presented in the Bible from the Genesis to Revelation. So, Patriology, it is the study of God the Father. Christology, it is the study of Christ, the God the Son, Jesus Christ. If you look at how God the Son or Jesus Christ was presented from Genesis to Revelation, so it is summed up over there and called as the Christology. So if you look at pneumatology is the study of Holy Spirit of God and the third person in the Trinity. So if you look at bibliology is the study of Bible. It is the study of scriptures. What scripture says and is there any error in the scripture? This kind of questions can be dealt in the bibliology. So soteriology. Soteriology is soterio. Soterio means salvation. So soteria is the study of salvation. So it talks about the salvation, how salvation came into this world, and how Jesus Christ give salvation to the whole world. These are some of the questions that can be dealt in soteriology. Next is ecclesiology. It is called as the ecclesiology. Ecclesiology is the study of church. Study of church. Ecclesia, it means church. So community, it is as a community or church. So it is the study of church, how church is there, and why the church came into existence in the New Testament, how the church was presented in the Bible, and is there any prophecies regarding the church, and how the church was constituted, is there any offices in the churches, and is there any offices like pastors, evangelists. These are some of the offices that are deals within the context of the ecclesiology. So next is called as the eschatology. Eschatology is the study of end times. So we have seen the study of end times and what is going to happen in the future over there. Angelology is study of angels. It talks about the angels and how the angels came into existence, and when they were created, and how they became Lucifer, or how they became as a demons on this earth, and those things will be dealt over there. So if you look at Christian demonology also there, Christian demonology means it is the study of the demons or ghost or something like evil spirit that is run after the Lucifer and his armies. So we will look in that Christian demonology from Christian perspective, how demons were presented, how demons were explained in the book of the Bible. So Christian anthropology. Anthropology means it's the study of humanity or a study of man. These are all Greek words. Anthropos and Christos, Soterios, Biblios and Pneumatos. So these are all Greek words. So Christian anthropology is the study of humanity. So HOMOSEXUALITY is the study of sin. I have told about it. HOMOSEXUALITY is the study of sin. So systematic theology deals with several streams. One of the stream is as the Christian eschatology. So what is Christian eschatology? It means eschatology is the study of what does the Bible talks about the end times. What does the Bible talks about the end times? How Bible look at the end times? How Bible look at the future? How Bible talks about the things or events that are going to happen in the future? That is about the Christian eschatology. So it is one of the branch in the systematic theology. So what are the things that are discussed in the Christian eschatology? Means it talks about the rapture of the church and judgment seat of Christ, and it talks about the tribulation period, and it talks about the how the rapture can going to happen. Is it before the tribulation, or midpoint of the tribulation, or the end of the tribulation, or after the tribulation, when it is going to happen? These kind of things it is going to be deal with. And also it deals with the second coming, how the second coming will be there, and why should be a second coming over there, and is the millennial kingdom literal or figurative language? Should we need to understand in a literal sense, or should we need to understand in a figurative sense? These are the things that eschatology deals with, and it talks about the end times that are going to happen in the future, and how the events are going to happen in the future. That is also explained in the eschatology, Christian eschatology. So when we look at the Christian eschatology, why should we study this Christian eschatology? So if you look at the Christian eschatology, we can understand that how we should live. When we study Christian eschatology, it makes us to impact on our lives, and how we should live our lives on this earth, and what should we expect in God's plan to be occurred in the future. How God is going to do the things in the future according to the Bible, it can be discussed in the Christian eschatology. From that we can come to know that how should we live, and how should be ready, and how should we get ready to the coming of the Lord, and should prepare ourselves for the waiting of the Jesus coming. So Bible talks about Bible, if you look at the Revelation chapter 6 to 18, there talks about the tribulation period, and eschatology deals with those kind of tribulation period, and what are the things are going to happen in that tribulation period. If you look at 6 to 18, there are seven seals, seven trumpets, and seven bowls. There are a lot of things are there in the Bible that are described in a figurative language and apocryphal literature that can be understood only when we study the eschatology in a proper line, and how end times is going to be. So if you look at Titus 2:13, the main verse for Christian eschatology, and which is based on this verse, Titus chapter 2 verses 13, it says like this: "We wait for the blessed hope, the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ." So we wait for the blessed hope, the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior. So when we come to know the Christian eschatology as a church members, as a student of the Bible, as a believers in Jesus Christ, we can have that hope in Jesus Christ, that we have the blessed hope. We are all waiting for that blessed hope that is going to happen in the future. The glorious appearing of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ promises that he is going to come again. He will come soon. So that's what he promised, and he will take the church from this head, and he is going to get married with the church members. That is going to happen in the future, and there will be a perfect fellowship with God in the millennial kingdom, and after that in the new heaven and earth. So these are the things, eschatological things that are going to happen in the future, that mainly discussed in the context of the Christian eschatology. So Christian eschatology talks about the end times and what are the things that are going to happen in the end times. I hope this video will help you to understand what is Christian eschatology and how eschatology would work or would explain all these features of the second coming, or all these future things. So eschatology, the word comes from the two Greek words, eschatos plus logos. Eschatos plus logos. Eschatos means end times or last days or last things. So logos means word. So it's a study of end times. So I hope this will help you to understand. Thank you.